and bitchy today. It's because I'm actually a little bit annoyed. I will explain in just a second, but just to kind of set the mood for today's video. Well, hello, my lovely... nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. Yo. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases that I do on my channel every Monday. This video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist and the community playlist are listed in the description box. My sources are there, discount codes are there, and the brands that I'm going to mention today are there as well. Before we go any further, let me kind of give a little disclaimer, the same one I gave last week, and that is basically I'm going to give you my opinion on new makeup releases, or maybe some older makeup releases that are new for me. I'm giving my opinion on them, and I either like it or I don't like it, or maybe I even think it's meh, or I have some more thoughts. It's about the products, not the people who make the products, usually. So if you are a brand owner and you are watching this video because I tagged you on Instagram and you don't really like what I have to say, it's not about you. Please don't take it personal. It's about your product that for one reason or another I may not like as much. But we cannot like everything, can we? Okay, let me kind of give you why I am a bit annoyed, besides the fact that I'm getting hungry now, which is also annoying. But yeah, basically I'm filming this video for the second time. Because the data got corrupted. I have new data cards and I don't really know what happened. Something happened there between me transferring it from the data card to my computer. Something happened and basically I lost all the footage. But not just from this video, from 4 videos. So I'm kind of annoyed by it. This makeup look came out of my being annoyed. So I really like how it came out actually. And it is done with this one, the Yaya from Miale Beauty. I filmed it kind of get ready with me style. Also trying the powder before foundation technique. Because it's still pretty warm here. I don't know when it will be up. I hope this week. I hope so. But yeah, that's basically it. So the reason that I'm annoyed is I'm now 4 videos behind. So... yeah, you know, so without kind of further ado, and that happened. If you want to know a little bit more about that, I will link a video underneath the cards that went up last Saturday, me explaining this a little bit. But I have also pre-filmed a bunch of stuff, especially a bunch of intros for my declutter series, where you will see probably the old setup. Or maybe I will just refilm the intro. It depends on how willing... I was distracted and I don't really know where I was with that. But yeah, basically this happened. I really, really do like how this is looking and how this is looking. So yeah, and maybe I'm getting a little bit less annoyed. No, I don't think so. Because I kind of know what I'm going to talk about. And it was such a shame because the video that should have gone up today was so fun. I thought I was hilarious in that movie, in that episode. But yeah, apparently the gods felt like I needed to do it over. So let's just... go to Instagram. Let's see, it's episode 98, so yay. I kind of have some updates and I have some new release. So let me go to the site here so I can look there on my monitor to see if I stay in focus, if I don't forget. Oh yeah, and still warm, fans on, that's basically... oh yeah, and window open, and apparently someone feels the need to throw stuff away now, just so you know. So if you hear a lot of banging, it's that. But let's go to an update from... let's start with this from Lucky Bunny Cosmetics, because here you see a picture of a palette. This is the inside of the Gluttony palette that I talked about last week. I really like the color story of this palette. I like the fact that she always kind of throws in something a little bit extra, you know. This is basically a blue palette with some greenish leaning shades, 2 neutrally shades, and a pink. So yeah, I cannot wait to receive it. I'm going to receive this in PR. It is already on its way. Maybe it has... I don't know if it has arrived already, or maybe it will arrive this week. I don't know, but I'm very, very excited to get it. If I have it, I will post pictures on my Instagram, so make sure you follow me there if you have Instagram, that is. And I will probably also put pictures up on Twitter. So maybe if you don't have Instagram, you do have Twitter. And if you have neither, yeah, then I cannot help you with... yeah, I'm sorry. Or not. But yeah, it's this is the inside. I'm very, very excited. I am on her PR list now. It's actually the first PR that I'm going to get from her. And I have a discount code which is linked down below. Let's go next to... This, yeah, Creepy Cosmetics. I mentioned this brand last week as well for the first time. And they were about to launch, but we did not really know when, or I didn't. And now I do, because they launched last Friday. So yeah, the palette is live. Did I not know the pricing as well? I thought I did. Oh yeah, so the price of the palette is $25. And it says here plus tax and shipping. I don't really know what that means. So I don't know. And the beauty sponges, she also has those, are $8 each. I will link her website down below. I think the palette looks gorgeous, guys. It is a very nice, it's a fall palette, but it is also a Halloween-y palette. And as you can see by my ensemble behind me, I am already in a Halloween, who am I kidding? I'm always in a Halloween-y mood, so yeah. But yeah, she's live already. What else did I have? Yeah, I have Odin's Eye Cosmetics. Do I know more now? Not really. What's this? Yeah, no, not really. Because I mentioned this 2 weeks ago, the Ulva 2 collection. Ulva, I think it's Ulva. I hope I pronounced that correctly. But you see a few fuzzy pictures. And basically, I see here a palette with half cool tones and half warm tones, but that's not all, because what I understood is that it is a pretty big collection, and I know that Angelica Nykvist is getting it in PR. I will link her channel down below. I'm very, very excited about this, because I don't know, looking at this, the way that this looks, yeah, that's the bigger palette, but it also appears that they are coming out with smaller palettes. I'm very, very curious about what they have, and I like the whole aesthetic that they have. It's just, I like it so, so much, and the quality is amazing as well. I have their Freya palette, and it is one of the favorite palettes that I have in my collection, because not only is the color story very unique, at least for me, but from what I see, yes, it's a warmer toned palette, but it is still a unique palette. I do have videos with that one on my channel, and maybe I need to pull it out again if I have the time. I do really want to play with it, because all the looks that I created with it are gorgeous. So yeah, let me know if you are excited, and if I know more, I will let you know probably next week. So yeah, what else? Is that everything that I have from the update? Yeah, this is everything that I have from the update. So then I have two sneak peeks, I think. Yeah, let's go to the sneak peeks next. Let's start with this, which is basically a rebrand from, I think she was called Oh My Glitter Oh My God, or Oh My Glitter OMG. She was based in the UK. She stopped with that brand, and I knew that. She announced it, and now she is starting with this. And this will have launched yesterday, today as I'm filming this. And this is Mad Moments Limited. I don't know if it is makeup or anything as I'm filming this. I have no idea, but I do know it's a new brand. I will link the website down below for you to check out for your convenience. Let's next go to this from Menagerie Cosmetics. This is their Arthurin Blush Palette Volume 1. Can I just say, I love the artwork. The artwork is so stunning, and her artwork is always stunning. It's a 9-pen blush palette, and it launches August the 29th for pre-order. I kind of have thoughts about it. I feel that especially bigger face palettes are kind of getting out of style, and I actually think that it would have been better if she were to come out with either singles or duos, or maybe even quads, you know, instead of a big 9-pan palette. But I do think that you can have a wider range of people in your that you can accommodate a wider range of people. Maybe that's a better explanation. If you were to split it up in, for instance, I don't know, quads or duos or singles, I also think that actually people will buy more, because I don't know, for instance, this is a pink palette, a pink blush palette. There will be shades in there that I would be like, oh, that is gorgeous, but there will also be shades in there that I'm like, yeah, maybe not so much, you know. And if you have more shades in a palette, the chance that that happens is greater. So I actually think that if you were to bring out singles or duos, that people will be inclined, oh, I like that one, oh, I like that one as well, oh, I like that one. So maybe at the end of the day you order then more, but that is my thought. Let me know down below what you think of it. Now I'm going to rant, because I'm kind of pissed off about with Menagerie Cosmetics as well, and it is not personal. This is purely from a business standpoint. Keep us updated. When you are, even though you are a smaller brand, and she is a smaller brand because there are just two of them, and I am well aware of that. But if you are an indie brand that is international, that has international customers, that has international fans that want to buy your products, don't just put out a story that will get away in 24 hours saying that you don't ship internationally because of the whole virus thing and the problem with shipping. And I understand, please don't get me wrong, I do understand that. Make a dedicated post so people know. I don't see every story. I am glad that one of you actually tagged me in it or told me, because I had not seen it. So I do understand why they don't ship internationally, though. I do understand it. The other thing is that now there is going to be a sneak peek or of a new release. Several people have asked underneath this post if it would be available internationally, including me, twice. The last time was yesterday. No response. And from a business standpoint, that is not really handy, is it? Because I want to know if I am... if I am able to get this. I'm not in the US, you know. Keep us updated. You don't have to be elaborate about it, but underneath this post, in the bio, just say so. I'm so sorry, guys. I don't ship internationally yet because it's still a mess. Or we are trying to ship internationally again. Keep us updated. Not just say, this is going to be released then and then and then. And then nothing. For your international customers, who are also a very large portion of...
Editing me here, I thought let's insert a little piece because I feel like I'm not getting my point across as per usual. Basically, I did see that Menagerie has pinned the story where they are telling us about their international shipping problem in their main page on their bio and Instagram, but almost no one checks that. That's what you see underneath a post of the new release. If people were to check the bio, the question wouldn't be asked. People don't check that. I did not think to check that. I did now while I'm editing. That is why you hear the insert. But basically, just, you know, it's a small effort. Just like when you say when it will launch, say international shipping has resumed or we are still not shipping internationally, especially if you know that you have a very large international fan base.
So yeah, and I am, it's not that I am not sympathetic with this, because I am. I understand how difficult it is to ship international. I know how expensive it is. I know that there is a lot of frustration for customers, but also for brands, because especially USPS, which is your biggest shipper, has so, you know, basically a shitty record right now. I get it. All I'm asking for is that you keep us updated, and not in your stories, but on your timeline. Is that too much to ask? That's it. For the rest, I really am interested in how the inside looks, but I don't think I'm able to get it. I don't know. You know? So yeah, that's basically a little bit of a rant, and it's not just for them, it's just that this applies to Menagerie Cosmetics right now, but it is for all the brands that ship internationally, also brands that ship internationally outside of Europe to the US. Keep your customers informed. If you are having trouble with shipping, and there are a lot of them who really do that, but if you're having trouble shipping, let your customers know. On the other hand though, customers, if there is problem with shipping, it is not the brand's fault. So if the brand has shipped it, it is basically out of their hands. So please do not bash brands for problems with shipping when they have shipped it already. It's not their fault then, it is the shipping company. And I want to make that very, very clear as well, because I see that happening too, you know, and it's not fair. So yeah, that's a rant kind of going both ways. I need to change my battery because it's flashing. Ah! Do not hit me with your socks. Okay, so battery changed, thrown back and all that. I'm still hungry. Let's go next to, let me see, because I was kind of hopping around a little bit. Let's go to a new release from Rebel Rouge Labs. This is their Howlin For You. I think it's a palette for Halloween. The pre-orders are live now until August the 30th. It will be, say, $30 now in the pre-order window, and after that, $35. And they will ship, what was it saying again? Ship early September? Mid to late September, that's when they will ship. So yeah, they are still working on the artwork, so if you want to know the final artwork, go follow them on Instagram. I really like the color story of this. The only thing I'm going to bitch about, because apparently it's that kind of video today, is the shade Ghosted. Unfortunately, that's a pressed glitter. I don't know their pressed glitter formula, but you know, it's not that I like the look of pressed glitters a lot. I think it's so cute and sparkly, but they are so, for me, a lot of the time, so uncomfortable because they get in the folds, and I just don't use them enough. I do really like what it looks like. I really do, and maybe these are amazing. I have no idea. There's only one pressed glitter in here, so that's good. I do really like the color story. I like the shade Illusion as well. That's very, very pretty. I have heard very good things about Rebel Rouge Labs' formula as well. So yeah, let me know if you are excited. I have not tried anything from them yet. Basically because a lot of the time the shades that I kind of want are pressed glitters. So yeah, then it's and I just won't use it then. So yeah, that's basically it. But I do really like this color story. Let me know what you think down below. Let's next go to this from DD Signature. Signature, that's the English word. I always want to say it in French or either Dutch, but that's basically the French word as well, which is signature. And I'm always kind of confused by both, but it's there I go again. Signature, that's it. Yes, signature. Yes, DD Signature collabed with Daniela Nicole, I believe. Is how you pronounce it. This is their Kiwi palette. It is available now for pre-order for, say, $28. The palette is set to ship on August the 21st, which is then also the official launch date. I like the color story of this. I don't really know if there are pressed glitters in here or very foiled shades. I cannot really tell. And it's a round palette. What I actually don't mind, but what I hope, because I would want that if I would have collabed with this palette, is I would have wanted it to be pettable, because a kiwi is also fuzzy. I don't know though if the outside of the palette is fuzzy, but it would be just bomb.com if it was. That's me though. I like techie shit like that. Yeah. So I'm actually very curious. Is the outside pettable? Would be fun. But yeah, that's just me, but I think that's fun. It's a round palette. I don't mind the packaging. A round palette can be just stored the way that I store them. You can just shove a round palette in there as well. Or maybe, you know, get one of those plates that you can put a plate on. Thingamajiggy. That will work as well. Do I have... Yeah, what the Lucky Bunny thingamajiggies, that's for letters. It's not for letters. It's actually for napkins. You can store something like this in that as well, you know? So, yeah, I like the color story. It's not specifically something for me, because I have this and I know that I have a lot of things coming in. This kind of thing as well, you know, with the Lucky Bunny color story. But I do think this is fun. I don't know. I think it's fun. Let's next go to... let's see what I have. This from Colortory Cosmetics. This is their pastel liner palette called Sweet Paradise. It's 8 colors and they are water activated liners. So basically they are cake liners in a palette. And pastel cake liners in a palette. And I know that I saw another brand do this as well. I just don't remember which one. Because they kind of made it seem, as I was reading the post, that's how it came across to me, that they had kind of invented it in a palette. They didn't. Oh, why do I have my shirt on backwards? Because it's that day, apparently. They didn't, because if you look at special effects water activated stuff, a lot of it comes in a palette. So it's not new. It's nothing new. But I do, and that's what I actually always wondered, was why brands did not do that as well. You know, I think that this is, for me, this is more versatile than a separate cake liner. You know, the pans in here are pretty big. You have enough room to just swirl your brush around. And it's easier to store. At least that's how I feel. And I have all the colors that I would want just, you know, in one. I have the same thing in my special effects kit, you know? So it's not specifically for me because I have water activated stuff. So basically I have cake liners or water activated paints. And I just don't use it enough as a graphic liner. I'm not that type of, no. It's also very drying for me and it emphasizes texture, so it's not for me. Let's go next to Sea Color Cosmetics because these are two brand new palettes. They are live on their website. I will link the website down below. And it is the Jungle Fever and the Sahara? No, Savannah. I think. I don't know. I tried to read the lettering. Yeah, they look cute. They are 10... Oh, Cabana. That was it. They are 10 bucks each. They have... Oh, they have... Yeah, they have more. They are basically a duping brand because the one called Cabana, the bottom one, reminds me of the Riviera from ABH. And I also see one here that is called Dusk to Dawn, which looks like the Jackie Aina one from ABH. They have basically Natasha Denona dupes. They have Jafar Starfish dupes. They have a lot of, well, basically duping palettes. So I don't hate that, actually. I don't mind that at all. But yeah, these look pretty. Let me know if you have ever tried this brand. And how you like it, if you have, though. Maybe you are excited. I don't know. Let me know. Let's next go to Posh Culture Cosmetics. Because this is their 90s baby mini palette. And it is... a 90s mini eyeshadow palette and an ultra shine lip gloss in a hot pink color. I think this is cute. I like neons. I like the whole aesthetic of this. I like this. When I look at this, this makes me happy. Will I get it? Probably not, because I also have this, the color story, because it makes me happy. But I do like this. I like the aesthetic of this a lot. I don't know. Let's scroll. I don't really know what it retails for either, which is kind of a shame because I'm very curious, but not curious enough to go and find out. I will leave their website down below though, so you can. Maybe if I feel like it when I'm editing, probably not, because it has to be today as well. I don't have time today. I don't have time. So yeah, let's next go to this from Moira Cosmetics. These are blush duos. They retail for $7 each. This is kind of what I meant when I was talking about Menagerie Cosmetics. This is... Yeah, I am more inclined to get this than to get a blush palette. And I am actually more inclined to get two or maybe even three than a complete blush palette. Does that make any sense? Even though this may be more expensive, but because I can really more customize it for me, I feel like I will get more use out of it, so more value for money, if that makes any sense. I like this. I like the colors that are here. I don't really know what I would do with a yellow and a red, besides eyeshadow. I know that you can use it as blushes, because apparently a yellow blush is gorgeous. I just think that on me, if a blush is too yellow toned, it looks like I have been hit in the face. But yeah, on other people it looks gorgeous. So yeah, maybe I should not drape then, because that is what I do. I like it when it goes up here. But I'm very interested in that one, actually. And I like the two ones that are beneath it as well. So the pinky ones and then the purple pink. I like the one that's on this side as well. The darkest one that you see. But I think it's, for me, it's too deep. But I do like the colors that are in there. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of this launch. Maybe you have tried them. Have you tried Moira Cosmetics? Let me know down below. Oh yeah, let's next go to... a brand that I am usually not featuring on my channel, and this is not really a featuring on my channel to promote, but this is basically talking about it so to give you alternatives. This is, you see the picture, you see what is being duped. I believe if you don't know, the orgy part is from Jeffree Star, further on calling him Jafar Starfish or the Pastel Skeletor, whichever way I am leaning that day. But yeah, this is his new nude snooze fest. Can I just say, I am so glad that I don't have to make up my mind if I want to buy this or not, because I know that this will sell out let's be real here, because all his palettes sell out. But this is just something that we have seen so many times. I know that I wasn't going to go there even, but I know that he mentioned a nudes palette. I think it was beginning this year or even last year, and I was very excited about it because I was like, he has such a unique eye to colors and to makeup. I'm very excited what he considers a nude palette. Well, it was not this. I did not have this in mind. Because this is just browns. And basically you see a few other palettes here. I will also put a picture up of one from Beauty Bay, which is their nudes palette. So yeah, and then also, you know, the fact that it is, what is it, a 36 pen matte palette, and then you get 9 shimmers in a separate palette. Yeah. But anyway, I wanted to give you options. So, are they the same? No, they are not the same palettes, and you will not find a dupe shade for shade. I am sure of it, but it will give you similar vibes. So you have one from ColourPop, which is called the Bare Necessities. BH Cosmetics has one. You see Lunatic Labs. You see a Makeup Geek and Artist Couture here. Really? Artist Couture? Where's... Oh, there's Artist Couture. And you also have one from Beauty Bay. Beauty Bay ships internationally. And they have actually a whole neutral line. They have warm neutrals. They have cool neutrals. They have something very similar to this. Not the same, but similar. So yeah, to give you alternatives. And if you came to my channel because of my... Jafar Starfish, especially the swatching videos, and especially his last palette, the swatch video, pulled in a lot of people. Yeah, I'm not going to feature him on my channel anymore. And if that was the reason that you are here and you want to unsubscribe, I totally understand. Because yeah, it is what it is. It's just, I cannot support him anymore. Just so you know, I cannot separate his makeup from the person that is behind the makeup in this case. Just saying, there are just some boundaries that he has crossed for me, and that I am not willing to overlook just for the sake of slapping an eyeshadow on my eye, when there are actually very nice alternatives out there as well. So yeah, that's basically it. If you do want to buy this, I'm not judging, because everyone needs to spend their money where they want to. You know, I am not judging anyone. I'm just telling you what I personally don't want to do on my channel anymore. And if you disagree, That is your prerogative, you know? I'm not going to hate you for liking something that I don't, or for wanting to support something that I don't, in this case, makeup related, you know? So yeah, let's next go to this, which is from Wicked Sister Cosmetics. This is their Invocation of the Spirit palette. It is inspired by the movie The Craft. And you get a 15 pan eyeshadow palette, and you get some lippies. And when I look at and the hat, I believe, when I look at this palette, it really gives me the vibes of that movie. I love The Craft, the movie. I love it so much, and it is very reminiscent of that. It is not specifically for me, but I kind of am pulled in. I kind of really am intrigued by this color story, because it's kind of jarring to my eyes at the same time, but in an intriguing way. Does that make any sense? So yeah, I don't think I will get this though, but I am interested actually in seeing looks done. I'm sure I will see looks on Instagram. I've never tried Wicked Sisters Cosmetics though, so let me know down below how you like them, it, the brand. Let's next go to this from Makeup Maniacs Cosmetics. These are their new Halloween highlighters. They all come in a compact 57mm pen size. You can select a scent option. The scent options are Pumpkin Spice, Birthday Cupcake and Hazelnut. Birthday Cupcake, yeah. Hazelnut and unscented. Yes, they retail for $25 each. They are available for purchase now, unless they are sold out. I don't know how quickly these will sell out. And I have seen them do this last year and the year before that as well. I love this. I really, really do. This is so gorgeous. And you know, I think that if I were to buy this, I would be scared to use it, you know, because I don't want to mess up the embossing. But yeah, I like the cat. I like the web, and I like the skull with the bones. I also like the spiral though, the wheat leaf not so much, the middle one. and the other ones with the cats are bats, but they remind me of cookies. Yeah, the most versatile color wise for me would be the one with the Scully in the middle. But yeah, I would just I don't know if I would use this. So yeah, you know, it's just almost too pretty to use. It's too pretty to look at. But let me know if you have tried these. I know that they are the ones from last year were amazing as well. They were so cool. I love this stuff. Okay, let's next go to this from ColourPop. This is the ColourPop Candy Castle collaboration. It looks very pretty. When I actually saw this, it kind of gave me a little bit of Kraken Cosmetics vibe, because those that's a brand that has very soft shades as well. Yeah, I think this is fun. I like the oil with roller because it brings me back to way back when. I like the collection. I like the lippies. I'm not going to get anything, but yeah, I do like the some stuff of this. It's not specifically for me though. I know that Betty Jean has a video on it, and Amanda from Makeup Just For Fun has a video on this as well. I will link both their channels down below if you want to see swatches and seeing it used. But still, I think it's a fun release. Yeah, let's next go to BK Beauty and Britt Clark, because they have collaborated. And what I understood is that this is her favorite brushes from BK Beauty in a set. And they look very, very pretty. They look very soft. And I have heard nothing but good things about BK Beauty. I do really want to try them one day. So yeah, the set retails for $95. And you can use the code BRITCHES10 for 10% off. And I think this is just amazing. Yeah. Let me know if you have tried the set. I haven't. I know that some people have gotten it, but I have not really heard. And yeah, I think they're great brushes. I don't know, guys. Let me know down below your thoughts. I would love to try this set though. I think that the only brush I won't, well, maybe I would use them all. Maybe not the foundation brush so much, but maybe I would. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts down below. Okay, let's next go to this from Unique Beauty, and this is unique for me. This is so fun. This is the Beauty Magazine inspired collection. They are available for pre-order now, and it will ship the first week of September. You can get 10% off with affiliate codes. I don't have affiliate codes here, but they are out there. I just don't have one, and I don't really know of one either. On the top of my head, or at, I don't know, but I do really like these. So basically they are booklets, and you get three different color stories. I like them. I also know what the names are. Let's see. So the one with the pink and the blue in it is called Girls Trip. Then the one with the gold and the blue in it is called Nightlife. And then the one with the red, the blue and the green in it is called Fashionista. And I actually think I like that one the best, Fashionista. I like these, guys. I like these a lot. Do I know what they retail for? They retail for £14 each, because they're based in the UK. I like these. I like these a lot. I like the color stories. I like the vibe. I really do like them, guys. And the best thing for me, no pressed glitters. I like them. Let me know if you, maybe you have pre-ordered one already or all three. Let me know. Okay, I think this is the last thing that I have. Yeah, which is from Gamer Glam Cosmetics. And this is their Space Legend palette. It gives you shape, function and a bomb-ass storyline. That's what it says here. This post is pretty old, from the 3rd of May. I don't know if it is still being sold. But I thought it was fun and I wanted to mention it actually. Okay, so they also give free shipping on any order over $75 for both the US and international shipping, which is very cool. I think this is fun, guys. It looks like a game controller, basically kind of like a PlayStation or an Xbox controller. That was, I cannot find for the life of me the word that I want to say. I like the color story in here as well. I like this color story. I like the back. The background, it makes me happy to look at. It just does. I think this is a very, very pleasing color story. At least for me it is. Then you get in the center is a what's it called again? makeup eraser, no color switch. That was the word I was looking for. I don't use those because I feel they are too abrasive for my brushes. So I actually use something like this, which is a microfiber cloth, and then one of those sticky kinds, you know, that always stick to your fingertips. I use those instead of a color switch. And yeah, the packaging is bulky, but I still think it's fun. That, yeah, I like it. Let me know if you have tried this, because the post is older. This is actually a post from May. I think it's the only eyeshadow palette that they have. Let me know, guys. Let me know. Give me info. And I think that is it for this week. Yes, that is it for my new makeup releases, with a shirt that's on backwards and a little bit ranty as well. Basically, it's time to dedicate the video. I kind of want to explain the rules a little bit more, because I have seen people using the hashtag Nestlings that were not members. So basically, to have the video dedicated to you, you need to be a member, guys. And how do you become a member? Next to the subscribe part of my channel, next to the subscribe, there should be a join. If you click the join, you come into a menu where you can kind of see the rules of being a member. It's basically a subscription to the channel. It will cost you €3 a month, and for that €3 you get a very nice raven thingamajiggy behind your name when you comment. So if you see very hot pink ravens beside someone's name in the comment section, those are my members. And you also get special emojis during live chats and a dedication in this video, but only if you use the hashtag Nestlings, and you need to be a member. So you need to have a raven behind your name, you know? Otherwise, the dedication just don't work, people. Please don't feel pressured to become a member of my channel. You don't have to. Watching, commenting, you know, giving a thumbs up or even a thumbs down, sharing my videos, it's just so, so beneficial for me. And this week, the video is dedicated to, well, I actually consider her a friend now. And her handle is Squirrel of Mystery. I hope I say that correctly. She has been with me for quite some time. And I actually think, yeah, she was one of my first members as well. So, hun, this video is dedicated to you. Thank you so, so much for always commenting, always liking, always watching. I just love you. Thank you so, so much. And so, guys, thank you so, so freakishly much for being here, for watching the video. And I love you all. I am going to wish you a fantastic day as well, a fabulous evening. And let's say it together. May your foundation always match your neck and your data not be corrupted. Yeah. That's going to be it. Yeah. Thank you for watching. Bye, guys. That was so weird. But it's a weird day, so we're just going to roll with it.